So just a quick message before we get to the reaction. My friend Jake could really use some help. He's trying to find a new place to live and has a very limited window of time in which to do it. He has a lot of financial stress that he's going through. It's a whole thing. And as someone who personally went through this recently, I completely understand the anxiety and the stress that come along with that. So like I did, he set up a GoFundMe page. I'm going to link that in the description below. So for anyone who can help or wants to, please go check that out and do whatever you can. Even just sharing that link around to people you know could be of some help. I know a lot of us are going through it, but if anyone in the Nuke fam is ready and willing to pay it forward and help out someone in need, that would be very much appreciated and very cool. He's a good person with cats who depend upon him. So again, check out that link in the description. See if there's anything you could do. Every little bit helps. And now, let's get to that reaction. I'm Blake X, and this is another Nuclear Reaction. So it's time for something that I haven't reacted to in a minute. And by a minute, I mean forever, basically. Because today I'll be checking out some power/speed metal with another request from the Infinite List, the band Hybria, and their song Millennium Quest. This is another one that's been, wait for it, sitting on the list forever. So it's time to blow off the dust, strap on my headset, and see what it's all about. After my preliminary ramblings, of course. Now, I've never heard of this band, so a genuine first-time reaction. But I see the album artwork on Metal Archives, and it's interesting because it has more of a cover than I'd associate with a thrash band. Though the speed element is apparently there, so I guess it works for that, too. But yeah, just a little side thought. So I'll see how this one is, and then do a full lyrical breakdown afterward. And if you're new here and wondering why my videos run longer than some other reaction channels, that's why. I do an actual review after the reaction itself. It's a full immersive experience. And if you think that's something you'd be into, definitely hit that subscribe button and become part of the Nuclear family, then hit the bell for notifications. And the best and biggest way that you can support what I do here and help me to keep growing strong is by becoming a patron. That's patreon.com/nuclearreactions. It'll be linked in the description below. And $2 gets you in and gives you access to a bunch of different perks, like early or exclusive access to videos, the option to vote in polls, behind-the-scenes looks, reaction sneak peeks, so on and so forth. I'm also working on a vlog series. I'm kind of working on it. I want to get back to it a bit more often than I've been doing. But it's called Atomic Vlogs, and it's sort of like little side thoughts that I have, little opinions and perspectives, pieces of advice, things that aren't reactions but are still short, interesting little videos. And those are mainly going up on Patreon, though you may see some on the channel eventually as well if they become popular enough, if enough people like them. But yeah, I'll be doing more of those, and I'll put little clips of them, little snippets, at the end of some of these reaction videos, just so you can get a taste. But if you want to see the full thing, again, the first tier on Patreon gives you access to that. And finally, the highest tier, tier 4, has a really interesting perk. It lets you make a song request and push it to the head of the line, guaranteeing a reaction to it right away. So that's a special VIP kind of treatment exclusive to that particular tier. Otherwise, you can leave your request in a comment, and if I pick yours, it goes on something called the Infinite List. And if it's on that list, I will get to it eventually. But it may take quite some time, just like this one did. I believe Kel actually asked for this one all the way back in 2019, so better late than ever. Yeah, so I'm going to check this one out, see what it's about. Apparently, these guys are from Brazil, which is interesting. Okay, Hybria, Millennium Quest, let's see what it's all about. In 3, 2, 1, go. Whoa, right into it. That's speed metal, all right. Okay. Ooh, that's rubbing. This whole tempo is great. Okay, we're off to one hell of a start. This just like slammed you right into the middle of things, right at the very beginning, and I like that. It gave me a punch to the brain as soon as I hit play. And I was sort of expecting that, but I thought there was going to be a little bit more of an introduction and some buildup. But I like that they chose to do it this way. It just blasts right out of the gate. The guitar riffs, I really like. They're really, really powerful and catchy, and really... Yeah, I'm just going to stick with catchy. I can't think of another word right now. Anyway, the guitar work was great. The drumming is really good so far, and the overall tempo of the song. Again, I'm really feeling the speed metal. Now, when it comes to the vocals, for those who don't know, the soaring operatic vocals, especially male, that you often hear with power metal, it's not really 100% to my taste. They have grown on me. But when it comes to power metal, I generally prefer female vocals, unless we're talking about like Hanzi, because he's fucking Hanzi. But the vocals are, to my taste, decent enough. But more so than that, I'm really liking the instrumental work going on here. So let's dive back in. I like that series of drum rolls. All the power chords. Love it. Where the hell to pause this song. I did not want to interrupt that solo. There were so many degrees of variation in that solo. It had so many different textures and touches to it. I thought it was fantastic. I thought that was excellently done. And I wasn't expecting like right in the middle of the song right there. Like if I was expecting a solo, I was expecting it more toward the end of the song. But that was like, they just shoved that right in there and it worked. I really, really love that. And I don't know how to put this, but there are so many different flavors of headbanging and body movement that I'm feeling as I'm hearing this song. Like, there's some really good energy on this. I'm really liking this musically. So, Kel, this was a very good pick, at least so far. I'm really digging this musically. Again, my one little personal criticism that comes down to my specific taste as a music listener, as a metalhead, is that the vocals aren't quite my thing. If this had some harshness thrown in, then I'd really love it. Obviously, it's power / speed metal. They're doing their thing. I respect that. But the vocals, I like them, and they are growing on me, but I'd like some screams in here too, personally. But regardless of that, I'm really thoroughly, seriously digging this, 100%. So let's keep going. Okay, that's a change up vocally. Little trash snarl there. Never so well.
Okay.
this gives me so much energy. I'm really liking this song. Like, I'm feeling really good hearing this. I'm really getting a lot out of this. I'm really impressed by the guitar work. And just, again, the energy, the tempo of this, just the way that it makes me feel. Like, it really puts me in a great mood. It makes my whole body just want to move. You know, it makes me want to headbang. I absolutely really love this. Even despite the vocals, like, I think this is just a really good song. I want to hear more Hybria, I swear. Good pick, Kel. Sorry it took so long for me to get to it. Let's finish it up. As I like the vocals right here, he is changing it up. Was fucking awesome, man. I really, really like this. You know, I mentioned the drumming a lot in songs that I've reacted to in the past few months. It's something I've been developing an ear for, and I'm really appreciating it a lot more. And the drumming was great in this one. Like, there were, like, really good drum rolls. The drumming speed, for lack of a better terminology on my part, was very good. It served the song very well. And without the drumming being as good as it was, this wouldn't have the sheer power and heaviness that it did. But the number one takeaway for me from this song is the guitar work. The guitar work was just on point. The solos were epic. They were varied. They had degrees of different energy, different genre influences. Like, there was a little bit of an 80s touch to part of the solo that was earlier on in the song, especially toward the end of it. There was a little bit of a thrash element, dare I say it. The power metal element was obviously there. So it was a nice combination of different elements and different influences and a nice transition from one to the other without losing any power or speed or appeal of the overall solo itself. So all the soloing in the song was just on point. Loved the power chords, loved just the guitar work in general was just excellent. I think that was, I'll actually use the word incredible. I really believe that. It was very memorable, very catchy. It had the heaviness, it had the speed, it had the power. It had that great, great, great contagious energy. So I got a lot out of the guitar work on this. Now the vocals, I liked his power metal vocals. I did. It's not my first choice for vocals by any means. And it is something that I have to be in the right mood for, which today apparently I was. I did like that he changed his voice up a little bit more at the end, and he had more of that, like, typical thrash metal snarl. It was very familiar. I kept waiting for a bit of a yeah toward the end. But yeah, it was, if he was doing a little bit more of that in the song, it would have been even that much better. Because it shows that he's a multifaceted, multi-talented vocalist, but he was more so leaning on, you know, his highs, his falsetto, you know, just his very emotive power metal soaring melodies. That he was doing with his voice. But if he had gone down a little bit lower, pulled a little bit more from his diaphragm, leaned a little bit more into that snarl, you know, that typical thrashy, gritty, nasty kind of grain to his voice, which this song proved that he is capable of. And I don't know the name of the vocalist. Let me look it up here. Yuri Sonson. Okay. So very talented vocalist, much respect. But if he had leaned a little bit more into that, that was what appealed to me a bit more. So I preferred when he went and did those vocals over the power metal ones. But regardless, vocally, it was good. It was satisfying. But it's just that when it comes to this song, the instrumentals were really what carried it more for me personally, and really what I really dug about it. So many reallys in that sentence. It was just a great song. It really was. And it makes me want to hear more from Hybrid. I've never even heard of them, aside from the fact that I heard of them when I put this one song on the list. But I had never heard of the band before then. And, you know, it just never ended up on my radar, I guess. I don't know how popular these guys are. They're from Brazil, so. Yeah, the music, I just, nothing to criticize, aside from those little nitpicks that I mentioned. Aside from that, I thought it was damn good, so. Thank you, Kel, for the request, but we are by no means done. Let's go to Metal Archives here now and get into the lyrics. Okay. Underworld, rebel men are rising to break out, but my puppets can't know what is about. Curse their lives, rebel men must not show up until the gateway is crossed and the beasters enslaved. Millennium Quest, the gateway of fire, who reaches it first will rule the times. Perpetual power to rule the times. Illusion's land is overtime, I've dried and wasted all. Before ruin it down, I must cross the way out. Slaves can't know, but once the gateway is crossed, their bodies will fall down dead, so new slaves I must have. Millennium Quest is calling for the attack. Hear my spell, your spirit is held, you are reckless trespassers. All who tried to cross, faceless as enslaved, mesmerized they were, puppets they became. Caught by the spell the spirits were, there is no other way to reach the gateway of fire. They've got to cross the faceless lands, the only path to reach it, but to not be caught by the spell, the Ripper shall carry them on. Millennium Quest is calling for the attack. So I'm almost positive that there's a larger concept of work on this record, because this seems to have character names, and also just seems to have too much going on that isn't totally clarified for it to just be some kind of one-off song, you know? So while I don't have access to the overarching concept that this is probably a part of, unless I want to cheat, and I'm not going to do that as a reactor, I want to be surprised and I want my experience with reading the lyrics to always be genuine. So I'm not going to go and cheat by reading the concept. But given that I don't know the full background, that may handicap me a little bit when I do this review, but I'll still try my best to break this down and give my full perspective on it. Now, the first thing to note is that this song is broken up into two perspectives. Some verses are written by the narrator, and other ones are from the point of view of a character named Mr. Faceless. So, it talks about a gateway opening, right? That sounds to me like hell or something hell adjacent. Like, if this is a fantasy concept, then it could be any dark, hellish kind of world. And that's your very basic, badass, metal kind of loose concept or theme. You know, some hell-like place opening up, demonic entities taking over, yada yada. That's par for the course when it comes to stereotypical metal lyrics. And, you know, while more credit is probably due, depending on what the larger concept actually entails, from a first-timer's point of view, this does seem to mostly fit that mold in a way that isn't really too different or impressive, at least to me personally. But, you know, maybe my opinion will develop as I keep rereading this. But it seems like these beings from this other world are trying to pass through this gateway, and standing directly in their way is the character of Mr. Faceless. And it's possible that either he's the protagonist of the story, or that he's actually trying to control them and use them for himself in some way. Because it says, "Rebel men must not show up until the gateway is crossed and the beasters enslaved." So it seems like he wants them to cross, but that he wants them under his control. A very lesser Key of Solomon kind of thing, right? So that's interesting. And so the rebel men must be the warriors who are trying to fight back against these beings or these beasts, and maybe against Mr. Faceless as well, since it's looking more likely that he's probably the chief antagonist. And then you've got the traditional religious dualism represented in the black and white kind of struggle between good and evil. Because the Millennium Quest here seems to be the battle itself. And it says, "The gateway of fire, who reaches it first will rule the times." So that's a little bit Book of Revelations-ish, you know, and it's also a little bit traditional high fantasy as well. It's coming off as a sort of mixture of both. And that's not a bad thing, but again, there's just not much here in the lyrics department that feels unique or I'll put it this way. There's very little here that can make the song feel like anything other than cookie cutter. I'm just going to lay it out, be very blunt about it. And when I say that, I mean solely in terms of the lyrics, not the music. And for a record that came out in 2004, according to Metal Archives, I guess I just would have hoped or expected for a little bit more. Like, I don't know, man. Like, I could see this coming out in the 80s, and at that time period, the lyrics feeling very edgy and very metal in an exciting way, because those kinds of things felt more fresh back then, before they'd been done 5,000 times. But for an album that came out in the early 2000s, I don't know, I would have liked a little bit more change-up, a little bit more nuance, and, you know, it is what it is, but I'll temper that criticism by again noting that I'm almost positive that this is one piece of a larger story. You know, it would be strange if it weren't. So maybe if I had the full story, I would understand it a bit better. So, of course, feel free to leave comments below, filling in the blanks, giving me some backstory if you want to, unless you think it's too spoilery, in which case, if you want me to react to something else by Hybria, let me know that in the comments as well. But I gotta be honest, you know, between the hackneyed kind of story and the repetition of lyrics here, I can't really say that I like much of anything about this when it comes down to the writing. Like, the only little crumb here that I find mildly intriguing is the act of Mr. Faceless trying to control these beings. Again, it harkens back to concepts like, you know, like those in The Lesser Key of Solomon, or just anything, especially in medieval era Christian demonology that deals with the concept of evoking and binding demonic spirits, and then forcing them to do your bidding, you know, usually commanding them under the name of God or some angel, or with some Enochian prayer, which I've always found extremely curious and idiosyncratic, especially for that time period, because so much of the Christian thought then was to fear and respect God and to take no other idols before him, and, you know, that man was basically lesser than anything high and spiritual. But it's like, then you had all these books and accounts of demonolatry performed by self-professed Christians who would basically do it while using the religion as a layer of protection. Or more literally, a circle of protection. So it's there's a little bit of a hypocrisy there, you know? Because idolatry was a very big scandal back in medieval times, you know, obviously. So it's kind of weird how that little loophole was made for that particular context, you know. But of course, you know, hypocrisy is nothing new for organized religion, regardless of the times. But this song with the Mr. Faceless thing, it just reminds me of the hubris behind the idea of controlling some spirit or entity that's supposed to be so powerful and so much beyond us. Whether it's in the context of a fictional fantasy narrative or just religious practice in general. And even more than that, a hubris that's expressly forbidden or condemned in other areas of the very same religion. So that's just something I found a bit curious and mildly interesting. It's worth noting how the concept of a magic practitioner binding and controlling some dark spirit has still lingered today, especially in the realm of fantasy. But beyond that, you know, yeah, honesty is my thing, so I'm going to stick with it. You know, again, there's really not much else here to dissect or analyze. It's a pretty straightforward, check all the boxes, demonic gateway-filled dark fantasy story that, you know, fits metal stereotype lyrically to a T. And again, the only thing that might raise my opinion or understanding about the writing here is if I had the greater knowledge of the overall concept. But yeah, just not impressive to me lyrically. Very forgettable. So I have to take points away for the writing. I didn't enjoy the lyrics on this one at all, basically. You know, I just, yeah, I'm not feeling it. But conversely, getting back to the music, I thought that was damn good. So it's tricky coming up with a rating for this one. Because the vocals were not 100% to my taste, and because of the lyrics, I'm going to retract some points for both of those things. But the music itself, especially the instrumental work, once again, I thought was incredible. I'm definitely going to be listening to the song again. So I'm going to give this one a very strong 10 out of 12 on the Doomsday Clock. I think that's more than fair. So there you have it. That's one less item from the infinite list. And as I always say, if you made it this far, I really appreciate it. If you are new here, go ahead and subscribe. It's worth your time. There's much more content on the way, and plenty here to check out. Hit the bell for notifications. Check out patreon.com/nuclearreactions. Thank you, Kellen Dross, for the request. It was a very good choice. And until next time, much love and respect to the nuclear family, and I will catch you all very soon.
Hello, world. This is Lena from Infected Rain, and I want to encourage you to go check out Blake's channel, Nuclear Reactions. Go on YouTube, click it, and follow and subscribe. You're gonna be surprised how much good stuff is there. Stay metal.